The following segment is sponsored by University of Utah Health. Surgery can be scary, especially when we don't know what to expect. Dana with the University of Utah Health is here to tell us what to expect from specifically rhinoplasty recovery. Welcome, Dana. Thanks for joining us.
Anytime.
So today we're talking about rhinoplasties, which I know is a pretty popular procedure. Yeah. How do people know what type of rhinoplasty is right for them?
The best way to figure out is to come in and see us. So depending on what the goals are and what you want to achieve out of the rhinoplasty depends on what type we're going to perform. So the kind of two basic types are open and closed. Open is where we're going to do an incision across the skin along the base of the nose and on the inside, and then actually flip the skin up and do work on the cartilages and the bone underneath. A closed rhinoplasty, maybe a little bit of a misnomer because it's not completely closed, but we do make a small incision on the inside of the nostrils and do everything through that small incision so there's no skin incisions on the outside.
Well, fascinating. Mm-hmm. A lot of people may not realize that there's are those two different distinct yes. type of procedures. Typically, how long is recovery?
It depends a little bit on which procedure you're getting and what exactly you're getting done. The open procedure tends to have a little bit more work that's done with it, and so the recovery is a little bit longer. Usually after about 2 to 3 weeks, you're feeling a little bit better, but those first 2 to 3 weeks, you're pretty bruised, pretty swollen, and then things kind of get better and better from there. With the closed rhinoplasty, maybe a little bit easier just because we're not doing as much work. Usually we're not breaking the bones through a closed incision, and so a little less swelling, a little less bruising, and maybe 1 to 2 weeks till you're feeling, you know, really back a little bit to yourself, but still a few more weeks till recovery is complete.
Right. Okay. Well, let's talk 24 hours post-surgery mm-hmm. for either of those. Yep. What should patients kind of understand or anticipate? What are they going to be feeling?
Absolutely. So for both, you're going to expect to have swelling and bruising of various degrees. Definitely swelling that's on the nose, around the eyes. Some black and blue eyes are pretty common, especially if we have to do bony work. And then you can expect a little bit of bloody drainage from your nose just because the nose is kind of a bloody place, and yep. you can expect that a little bit afterwards. And pain is going to be managed with pain medicine, but you're going to have, you know, pain afterwards that we want to keep at a minimum, but it's still going to be there. You can expect to have a splint on the outside of your nose and possibly some stents or packing up on the inside of your nose just to help to hold the shape and keep things where we need it as it's healing.
I feel like this is so helpful because it's really kind of unpacking the whole process, what people can expect for what's become a really common procedure. Mm-hmm. For people wondering about work, should they take off work? Will they have to? Or
most people will need at least a week off of work, sometimes two. It depends a little bit on one, the procedure that you have and how much we're doing, and then two, what you do for work. So people who have more of a desk job or a sedentary job can usually go back a little sooner. People who really have a high intensity or labor job might actually need to take off a little bit more time before they're really able to go back full time to work.
Okay, well, let's talk about when will we really start to feel and look better?
Truthfully, it probably takes a solid 3 to 4 weeks to kind of have all of the bruising away and the swelling to subside. But the full recovery for a rhinoplasty actually takes about 8 to 10 months, and it's something that we counsel you on just because the nose is kind of a special place that it takes about that length of time for your final results. But you'll definitely feel a lot better after those first 3 to 4 weeks.
This is so informative. I'm learning so much. Dana, thank you so much. Where can people go for more information?
So you can go to our website. We have a lot of information on the website at the plastic surgery website for the University of Utah. And then also the best thing to do is just come do a consult with us and let us tell you the information that you need.
I love it. Thank you so much, Dana. This has been so great.
You're welcome.